obsessed with you.
Okay,
I don't know if you know. So, no, there's a long history that I have with Dear White People.
Okay.
So I work.
We've met before. Right?
I do the after show.
Okay.
For AfterBuzz TV.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay,
yes. No, okay. We've had a lot of your cast come
great.
To the show.
Okay, cool.
It's been amazing.
Awesome.
So please tell me. I first want to ask, what made you want to throw in, you know, Spike Lee, like kind of montages into your show? Because I feel like, you know, She's Gotta Have It just came out, and I feel like black culture is starting to collide a little bit, and we're starting to honor people within our art.
Absolutely.
So what made you want to incorporate that?
Well, you know, one of the big things for me as a filmmaker, and this really started happening with the French New Wave, you know, I got to go there, okay? I'm sorry. But, you know, you sort of pay homage to the people that open the door that you're walking through, and I felt it important for me to have, you know, such early success with my first project. Like, I gotta let people know, hey, if you didn't know, there's this dude named Spike, and he made these amazing things, and that made me feel like I could make amazing things. So I felt it was important to, you know, to always pay homage to the people that came before.
What was your favorite Spike Lee joint growing up?
I think my favorite joint growing up was Malcolm X. And it remains my favorite of his films. But Do the Right Thing, of course, huge, huge.
Mo Better Blues.
Mo Better Blues is amazing. But Do the Right Thing did something in my brain that, like, you know, it gave me an aha moment I didn't expect. Like, wow, you can shoot black people cinematically, and you can, like, we get to be colorful and interesting. We don't have to just be gritty and tragic. And that was a big, like, awakening for me as a kid. So, you know, yeah, it's important for me to at least let people know.
Absolutely.
He opened the door.
So in season one of Dear White People, you tackled a lot of controversial issues. Tell me some of the ones that you're going to tackle in season two.
Well, I have to get into the trolling of it all, because we certainly experienced that on a whole new level with the first season.
Oh, yes.
It was shocking, because, you know, we already made the movie, so I was like, people ain't going to trip on Dear White People now. Like, it's so passé.
Okay.
They trip bigger than ever before. And so that, to me, was an interesting community to explore and to research and to, like, kind of dive into, like a secret agent. So some of that we're kind of pulling apart in the new season. We, of course, continue to talk about black culture and the stuff that we watch and that we're fans of. And there's a lot to do with secrets this season, like people who you think you know, maybe you don't know. What are they keeping from themselves? What are people keeping from them? This idea of misinformation, we're really tackling it on a big level and a small level, too.
Absolutely. Yeah. And you came for my sorority, but that's okay.
I did not personally
for
anybody, I would like to say.
It's okay. Yes, no, it was very, it was a little sneak, and as soon as I saw it, I was like, oh,
yeah,
so okay.
Jerry Brown wrote that episode, okay.
He's like, look, it's not me, it's them. But no, and that's a part of black culture, so I
well,
feel
you know
like
what, we have a, it's a, listen, I put it on my Twitter account. Shade is my love language, okay? So shade has infected the whole writer's crew. We literally only shade the people that we love, so, you know, I'm sorry.
Hey,
for the inadvertent digs, but, you know, it's part of how we do a satire, you know? It's how
absolutely.
We have a comic voice. We have to laugh at ourselves. I mean, it's sort of like, it's a relief to laugh at yourself sometimes when you're black, because you don't really get the opportunity.
Absolutely. And yeah. One last question. I want to know, you know, the Golden Globes, they deemed Get Out as a comedy.
Yeah.
And I want to know, do you feel like black art isn't really misunderstood, or do you feel like there's a lack of care with black art?
Well, I have to, you know, it's different, because the Globes, it's, some of it is strategic. You know, they do have a comedy and a dramatic category. Get Out, in my opinion, is a satire, a brilliant satire. I don't know that I would immediately think of it as a classic comedy, but that might be a strategic play on someone's part to make sure that movie gets the shine that it deserves, because it is certainly one of the best pictures of the year. I felt that when I saw it in February. I remember I was arguing with critics. I was like, on Twitter, I was like, y'all, this is going to be at play at the end of this year, trust me. So, you know,
the best of all time.
I mean, I can't speak enough about how great that movie is. So, you know, I think there is, generally speaking, a misunderstanding about our stuff. We so rarely get to see ourselves in things, so oftentimes we can misunderstand the stuff that we're seeing, too. I've been guilty of it. Like, where am I in this? I'm mad. Where am I in this? And, you know, the difference is I'm a filmmaker, so I can put myself in things. But, so, yeah. But I think that's why we got to keep pushing. We got to keep making stuff so people start to get it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Justin,
thank
and congratulations.
You. I appreciate it. Good to see you.